It's not popular today to talk about various things, but just one little phrase from the scripture, the meek shall inherit the earth. The meek shall inherit the earth. Now, meek isn't weak, meek means gentle. Okay, just like the Lord Jesus Christ, who is by nature gentle. Now, of course, in the past, he has destroyed rather a large number of people. But why does he do that? Because it's childlikeness, innocence, and purity offended that makes him angry. Okay. But ultimately, in the end, when we come onto the new heaven, under a new heaven, and all the enemies of God, religious and secular, have been thrown into the lake of fire, and there was nothing to hurt or harm in all his holy mountain that he spoke about. When we come onto the new earth, then there isn't going to be anything else but gentleness and quietness. Now, unfortunately, because we live in the world we do, we don't start with this, do we, all of us? We start with being something, we are up for it, we are competent, we are capable, we're building careers, we're trying, we are doing this and that, and we're in charge, and we're going to do this. Meekness is seen as something that's pathetic. Well, actually, you get used to it, because actually meekness is the nature of God, and meekness is where we've got to get to. Viciousness, nastiness, and like, say, the Roman Catholic Church or the Muslims or Hindus or whatsoever, is the nature and character of Satan. To be tough, independent, and self-sufficient is to be a goat. Sheep are meek and quiet, and they need their shepherd. They know their need for their shepherd. They are not self-willed, are they? And remember that it is only going to be the sheep that's going to be in the new creation. All right, the new creation's after Judgment Day, more than 1,000 years down the tracks here. Fair enough, it's a long way away. But however, this is the time when we are prepared and we are changed into the image of Jesus Christ to be just like him. If we're going to be a member of that family, with the family character and nature, then we must also become just like him, by nature. And you can't do that in and of yourself, of course. Initially you are born again, and then there is the trial and the testing and all this kind of stuff, the pressing into the kingdom, the pressing into the conformity of the work of the cross. So all trace and nature of your flesh and your old ways of doing things is exterminated, and the extant nature in you is the new nature. Okay, the new nature replaces the old nature, and you're just not at all like you used to be. However, traces of this meekness seem to me to exist from when we were born into this world. And I've noticed that children of the devil, the goats, they absolutely despise meekness. They see it as pathetic and weak and useless and all the rest of it. It's not like that at all. Meekness is about gentleness, which is associated with holiness, and which is innocence and purity, like a little child. Except you be converted, and conditional, and you become as a little child, you shall in no wise enter the kingdom of heaven. Before you die, we enter the kingdom before we die. Remember, you know, death only seals where you're at. If you aren't already in the kingdom before you die, you won't be found in it afterwards. All right. But meekness is associated with the very nature of God: holiness, innocence, purity, goodness, all the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance, long suffering. Now that's the new nature. Let's live in that, and let's not get caught up with the false vine people, Satan's Christians, church. That woman that rides the beast you see in Revelation 17 is church without question. Okay, Babylon the Great, whether it's the dire and deadly abominable befrocked at one end of the spectrum or the pink and fluffy manic muppets of charismania at the other end of the spectrum is irrelevant. They're not with him. They're not his people. The meek shall inherit the earth. We can't have wolves in sheep's clothing in amongst us, because they haven't got that meek nature. And I know people. I didn't understand what on earth was going on. I was totally confused as a baby Christian. If wolves in sheep's clothing, and I could name some, get into a fellowship, it causes bedlam and chaos and people rushing in all directions trying to get away. It causes strife and bitterness and problems and all kinds of horrors going on, doesn't it? And that damages the sheep. There's nothing wrong with meekness, gentleness and quietness. You can't have these motor mouth, microphone licking creatures like you see on God TV or Revelation TV. I mean, I was looking on the other day at a man on Benny Hinn's new channel, Love World USA, God help us. And there was a man, I don't know who he was, but he got a guinea pig hairdo, is the best way I can describe it. There he was, into a microphone and stuff. But is that meekness? You see, this shakes a child of God to the core. What on earth is going on? You know, as a child of God, just born again and whatsoever, they're terrified at the horrors that's actually going on in the name of Jesus Christ. And this can really overhaul our hearts and cause us to be discouraged and lose faith and all these kinds of things. And we've escaped all that because we don't want to be in the false vine, who are very much involved in everything that's anti-meekness. They want power and glory and victory and all the rest of it, don't they? Yeah, nuts, isn't it, the whole thing? But nevertheless, let's just remember this: it's the meek who inherit the earth. So if you're feeling weaker than other people, or you are feeling that you're not in great earth-shattering ministries and all this kind of stuff, you're not some kind of TV showman, or you're like the strutting showman with a microphone in their face you see up and down the stages of churches up and down the land, then you be encouraged. They're going to get burnt, because that ain't meekness. The men of God I've known through history who've had the most effect on me, that I've been most impressed with, has always been those who are meek and quiet and gentle. Very quiet, unassuming people, nothing to look at, just like Jesus himself. Those motor mouths with microphones begging for money all the time and all this kind of stuff, full of bravado and what they've done and everything else, they're a million miles from meekness, aren't they?